Okay, so I went to go do a level 3 to test out my brand new battlecruiser, and it just happened that it gave me Garista's Extravaganza, which I may very well not be able to do at all in a battlecruiser. In fact, I know I couldn't do it in the MOA, and I know that it's just going to be really tough. Like, I don't think I could even do level 2 security or Extravaganza in a MOA, but I do want to see what this old girl can do even with the half-ass fit I've got on it. Or to most people, quarter-ass fit. That's a slippery slope we're going down. Either way, I don't know. It seemed to do pretty well in that level 4, but I was not tanking all of it, or even probably most of it. And I certainly was not having to deal all of the damage. And that's a big indicator! Whoa! I forgot my drones. Yeah. Brain! I got Vespas this time. It unfortunately is not a moped. I was hoping that that would be a moped, but it was not. I wanted little moped drones. The one thing I'm hoping is that they won't have a bunch of missile cruisers firing at me from like 60 kilometers, because I won't be able to close that distance very easily. Here's hoping we don't get rectified. And there they are. Oh, there's the Infernos. They're close. I want those. I want them real bad. Looks good. I guess a lot depends on how much damage I did to them. Not very... They're fucking shooting missiles at my drones! What the fuck?! What is with everything in this game hating on my drones? I guess it's kind of a good thing because I'm not doing a lot of damage to this Inferno, and they might just jack me up if they... Okay, they've killed one of my drones. Did the Vespas live? No. They killed one of my Vespas. What is going on? Oh shit, there's frigates that way. Go this way, go this way. Okay, they're not doing any damage to me. No, they are. I don't think there's any scrams in here though, so I can maybe fuck off if things get a little too harsh. Oh good, they're leaving my drones alone. Thanks a bunch. Oh, these Infernos, why? Shit. They're very hard to kill, and they have a lot of shield regen. That's lovely. Okay, well, that's one ship down. Not a good time. Can't even send my drones at you yet. What are you doing? I'm taking fairly significant damages. Should probably switch you guys back to aggressive. And they're gonna do their own thing. Hopefully they choose to fight. I choose you! Choose to fight, please! Shield regen on these things is ridiculous. Oh, and of course they're not fighting. Stupid drones! That one's too confused to even orbit. There we go. Do your dirty work. Please. Please. Why? I'm liking this passive shield tank, it's not quite good enough. And now somehow I'm outrunning that stupid frigate. Of course. Kill something, drones! I'm gonna turn around here. I'm thinking it might not be a good idea for me to keep that guy at long range. Gives him more time to regen his shields and flight time. Plus, I gotta get my drones on something. These guys will be in range soon. Oh, that's an assaulter. That's a battle cruiser, I think. He's probably responsible for a great deal of the damage I'm taking. It looks like my Inferno is doing less than my Scourges, so I'm gonna switch over to all Scourges. Scourge! Although, that's largely on shield, so I don't know. Yeah, they're damaging me very fucking slowly, but more than I can regen. Please die now, Inferno. Fuck it. Okay. I fired a volley at nothing for no reasons. Oh no, it went off the, frigate. I don't know what a Koyakin is, but he's very damn slow, whatever he is. And I can't hit him with my missiles. Of course. Well, I might be able to take out one more of these mortifiers before I have to leave, but... sadly, it looks like I am going to have to leave at some point. Oh, hey! Go! Go, my dronesies! Kill him! And that's not good. The damage is picking up pretty steadily. Decent armor on this thing, but I still would want to get out of here before they started doing solid armor damage. In fact, I think I'm going to go ahead and align. If the camera would stop shaking, please. Ow. Actually, let's align to this. That mortifier is actually out of range of my missiles. Just about. Which is sad. Maybe we can take out this frigate, though. I think it's doable if I warp out and then warp back in. I can kill this frigate. Oh god, that damage. Oh no. Oh god. Why? Am I hurting him at all? 40 apiece? That's so bad. And they've almost killed my other Vespa. Oh, they got it. You filthy murderers. His shield is almost down. The system is almost down. The system is almost down. Never mind. It's back. Oh, I wish I did damage. Maybe I should be using something else for this guy. Please die, frigate man, so I can come back and not have a frigate man. Please. I have a feeling... okay, so for one thing we know for sure is that this is not worth my time. Because it... how slow everything is going, so we know that for sure, but what we don't know is if it's possible to do at all. Okay, let's go. If you can make it back in time, then so be it, Mr. Drone, but if not, then go fuck yourself! Well, I'm gonna go pick up a couple more drones and see if I can muddle through this very slowly, but I think I need better fittings and skills before I'll be able to do this kind of mission effectively. But I imagine what this does tell me, though, is that a regular level 3 mission would be doable in this, just not the extravaganza variety. Oh, well. I'll probably at least finish this one room if I don't finish them all. Who knows? Well, this room doesn't actually seem that bad. I went and put a second adaptive invulnerability field on my ship. Oops. And, seems to have helped. Although it does eat through my capacitor, the thing is that my capacitor is not really used for anything else, so why not give it a go? The only remaining issue being my crappy range and rate of fire and damage, but with time comes skills, and comes damage and murder. It's only a matter of time. What are you even shooting? Is it the silencer shooting my drones? Everyone hates my drones! Okay, he switched to me. What an asshole. The one thing I'm worried about here is that there will be a spawn trigger amongst this, because it seems like a pretty weak gate. Who knows? Time to silence the silencer. Shh. Quiet you. Oh yeah. Easy money. It's hard to be silent when you're on fire and exploding. These heavy missile batteries hit me really hard, and there's a big blue thing. I'm gonna go this way now. Hopefully that big blue thing won't shoot things at me. I think it's some sort of bubble protecting the control tower, but that's not my problem. I have to be careful for one thing, though. I know that these extravaganza missions have a final room, and I know that they're incredibly difficult to deal with, and I don't want to go anywhere near it. But I don't know. Let's see here. A transport ship. I don't need to target you right away. Let's stick to the murder ship, shall we? Fortunately, it seems like the incoming damage is a bit slack. I may even survive this encounter. Depends, though. Most of the enemies aren't even in range of me right now. And I plan to keep it that way. I may be able to not aggro those guys if I stick over this direction. That'd be nice. Oh, of course. Stop shooting my drones! Fuck! Way to go, assholes! Good shot. Okay. Now we can actually do the thing. Plus, with all these crazy resistances, I'm actually taking it very well, so I think I might be happier with this build than I had initially thought. It's very resistant to things. Now, though, those guys are hitting me from far, far. Abolisher? Where the hell is that? Oops. Oh, what are you? Oh, that's a transport ship I didn't want to target. Wow, that guy's hitting me from 51. Let's go ahead and see if we can get towards him. Might as well kill this guy while I've got nothing else in range. Now that'll be quick. Silencer's there. The abolisher is well in that bubble. I don't think I want to go in that bubble. I'm just going to go ahead and toss that out as a guess. I'm also not taking enough damage to warrant the second invulnerability thing, and I think I'm cap stable with just one, and just barely not cap stable with two. Almost in range of one of the silencers. You must die. Are they evading me? I think they're running away from me. I really don't know what to do with this bubble thingy. Maybe I should yell at it. What is that? Oh, that's the other transport ship. Well, it looks like all the murdering is going to happen down here. But yeah, no, I think I'm in virtually no danger whatsoever for this particular part of the mission. I guess those heavy missile batteries were about the toughest thing I had in here to deal with. Well, that's good to know. It looks like I have to destroy this force field. In the meantime, I get to enjoy watching my drones bounce off the edge of it. Oh no, I think they are hitting it. I don't think they can go inside of it, though. Yep, nope. Ta-da! And I'm gonna go ahead and blow up this control tower because it looked at me funny. At least that's what I'm gonna say. And I like shooting stuff and making things explode. Pew-pew. Brap, brap. Murder, murder. Oops. What am I doing? Off to see the wizard then, looting up the stuff and going on to the next gate where I'll probably die a lot. I keep saying that, but you never know. Oh, it didn't give me anything but that. That's better than loot. Kaboom. Yeah. This looks really neat. Cruising along this huge object, firing missiles. Unfortunately, I don't do jack shit for damage against this guy, and I appear to be stuck on this object. So much for looking neat. I need to go get more drones. They keep murdering my drones. I should probably stick to the light scout drones until I get a different ship, because this thing's got 25 drone capacity, and that's an odd-ish number, because that means 2 medium, 1 light, and it's just not working out for me. So I think I'm going to go all light, make them a little bit harder to hit and kill, and take the damage penalties. Anyway, the thing about the drones is that I can carry backup drones if I go with all light scout drones. Am I even going to be able to get this thing? It's like embedded in this giant clusterfuck of a space station. I want it. Give it to me. Please. Anyway, I know that the next room is full of fucking frigates, so I'm gonna have to go and get more drones, because I can't hit frigates for shiggets. Neat. No. Well, even this room doesn't seem all that particularly difficult. For some reason, my missiles are doing a great deal more damage to these frigates than they used to be as well. Like, about twice as much. I think it's because I am a beautiful man. That's the only explanation. I do like this drone setup, though. I like having disposable drones. I believe that is how they're supposed to be. However, there is another target over there. There's a spider drone and Satori Kadoon, who's flying a battleship, Ferox, of some sort of make and model. I wonder what his bounty is. 130,000? Ha! Hardly worth even killing him. The missiles will probably honestly cost more. No, not quite. In the meantime, pew pew lasers, he said while firing missiles. Well, I can't hurt the spider drone very much with my missiles. I might need to switch to EM, because look at that shield tank on it. Oh my goodness. Goodness gracious. And it's very, very fast. And I'm webbed. Huh. Huh. It's outrunning my drones, and they are missing it. That's not good. Kill, please? It's almost outrunning my fucking missiles. Oh, man. Alright, at least one of these. No, I'm going with two. Nope, all three. All EM. Save me, Mir Mir! I'll get to that other guy in a minute. He's not doing any damage to me, so. In fact, I don't think either of them are really doing any damage to me. This should hurt him fairly badly. You must die. Or not. Well, it does more damage than I was doing. I think. Slightly. Goodness, this guy's annoying as hell. Maybe I'll just have to kill his boss and hope that they leave me alone. Now we can just kick back and enjoy the fireworks. The Mjolnir's definitely helped. But so did the drones. And I'm glad I haven't lost any. So there's a few things here I can loot as well. There's a tactical outpost and a storage silo. I don't think any of these other things, like the shield generator or the wall things, drop anything, but might could be. Whoa. Tactical outpost. And great wall. What? The Great Wall of Garista. Is that connected to something? I don't know. Alright, now we get to find out if one of these guys dropped the tags, and if not, then we won't have any choice but to not do the bonus room. But we should probably maybe do the bonus room if we can. I don't think any of them will have dropped. It requires some kind of special item to open up the gate, and I don't think we have it. Even if we did have it, it might not be a good idea to do that anyway. No bad tractor beam. Give it to me. Give it to me. Rats. Time to blow up some buildings. I like the explosions. Aha! It actually dropped a thing. I knew it! Quick, before my vacuum cleaner. Give it to me. No! Stupid vacuum cleaner. Always out against me. No key, but an implant. Ooh. 3% reduction in capacitor needs of all mods requiring the shield emission system skill. Isn't that what I'm training right now? No, tactical shield upgrades or whatever. Interesting, though. Not too shabby, I suppose. Implants are always welcome. And fortunately, though, that means no bonus room for us. But still, we did Garista's Extravaganza level 3 alone in a Drake. That's an accomplishment of sorts, I guess. Let's just see if it'll let me through, just for fun. Rat! No bonus room for me. I guess I'll get to keep my ship today. Well, we've got our plank of wood fitted out, and it's mostly just shield tank stuff, passive tanking. It's very strong in that regard. Good at doing missions, and good at helping out teammates with stuff. So that's about what I wanted it for. So having said that, now we can put it away and not use it for a while I do some mining to cover the cost. Costs us around 50 mil to purchase and kit. So I'll have that in mind. Probably made... Oh yeah, I made around 7 million in between there somewhere on some ammunition that I sold. But in the meantime, we need to start thinking about getting our production queue going again and getting mining going. And our corporation has grown in size, and we have a lot of new people. Not a lot. We've probably got around 10 to 15 active members. Still trying hard not to grow too fast. We're trying to be very selective with how we grab people. Trying to get some people that are old and new, and people that are just sort of not rabid Jeff fans and are interested in playing Eve for whatever reason, just want to play. So I think that's been going well, and we've got a few more options open to us. We're going to start scheduling events like mining events and maybe some fleet mission events, or maybe even some PvP roaming. I don't know. Who knows? At least the options are there for us now, as opposed to before, they were pretty limited. Right now, we've got someone blowing up a inactive player-owned station in Senka owned by some now-defunct alliance. They're going to spend all night blowing that up so that they can put down their own and have a home base somewhere here in Senka. Possibly. I don't know. I guess that's up to them. But, yeah, cool shit going on. As for me, I'm probably going to be spending a lot more time in the Canterbury, our retriever, doing a whole lot more mining, but I'm really, really happy to have the plank of wood here to replace our fried chicken wing, the Moa, who was introduced none too kindly into a stealth bomber. So yeah, we have a lot of blueprints to work with here. Some copies, some originals, and we have a lot of stuff I could go and sell a bunch of this stuff, but I don't know. I almost think it'd be better to just reprocess it, because some of this stuff is not worth the time it would take to ship it up. I've also still got some ore here, not too much. I would hope to stockpile some of it. I'm curious, though, because last time I checked, the prices on Veldspar had been going up to the 20 region, which was really nice. So yeah, I think I'm going to get back more into my financial mode now that I've taken a little time off to sort of reinvigorate our corporation and do a little bit of murder stuff to make, mostly just to make myself available to people. Because there are times when people, you know, want or need someone with a tanky battlecruiser to come help out with something. And now I can do that. So that's fun. Anyway, back to work. And this is going to be, hopefully, a player-owned station blowing up. Oh, wow. That is pretty. There was a inactive corporation's player station here, and they'd been inactive for quite some time. Somebody had a alternate corporation declare war on them and take it out to free up the spot. I guess that's how it goes when your structures get abandoned. Anyway, we're just observers, but still wanted to catch that. That's pretty cool. And then, boom, there goes another fucking control tower. That one will be in our corporation, though. So that's pretty cool. I believe that will be, anyway. I guess that's up to the owner. But, yeah, no. Haven't got to see one of those before. I believe that took somewhere along the lines of 14 hours to destroy. So if anybody had cared about it, they would have come by then. Still, Real estate being what it is, gotta get the spot while you can. This is nice. We got ourselves a little mining fleet. Not all together right now, because we're just operating on station-wide or system-wide boosts. But check this out. With the boost that I'm getting from these guys, my cycle time on the strip miners is down to 120 seconds from 3 minutes. So cut a full minute off and increase the range and yield. So really, really handy for getting the minings done. The benefits of having friends, and then Treat can sit here and hobgoblin me if I get into too much trouble, I guess. So much purple. Many rocks destroy. Kill rocks. Die, rocks!